Allora, heavy weight, 91 kg plus, oltre i 91 kg di peso. Due atleti veramente, veramente interessanti per questo
ultimo match. We're back again here for the final part of the evening. It's the heavyweights. It's a highly anticipated contest this is this evening. You can see there, Dolce & Gabbana, Italia Thunder holding the 4-0 advantage. Can they produce a whitewash? It would be a major surprise because we've got a massive talent, a superstar of World Series of Boxing in his first season as well. Alexander Usyk is our man this evening. He'll come up against Matteo Mundungo, who the Italian, the second Italian to fight for the Thunder this evening. But he's got his work cut out against the Olympic and the world champion. And we're talking about big superstars in the World Series of Boxing. They don't come bigger than this. This man here with a 4-0 record in the World Series of Boxing.
So. 4 vittorie su 4 match disputati all'angolo blu per gli Otamans, Jaime Otamans, Alexander Usyk.
Usyk in the ring, as I said, Olympic champion, and in the Olympics he defeated Clemente Russo 14-11 in the final to claim that, and also world champion. He lost to Clemente Russo in 2008, but when he was a younger man, and but now he is the Olympic champion at 26, and when you're talking about real superstars, Usyk is there at the top, and no doubt Clemente Russo will be watching with very closely this bout, as Matteo Mundungo, his teammate, will take on the superstar. And Mundungo is a former pro. He's undefeated as a pro, but he's never had a tougher bout than this one feels in his pro career in Italy. And he comes up here this evening towards the ring, and he's a big man as well. He really is. He's coming at 96. Both are in at 96, both big men. He's carrying a few pounds around the mid rift as well. And he's from the city of Piacenza. And in the pre-fight press conference, he said, well, nothing really to lose, I'm the outsider. Usyk is the all-conquering fighter at the moment. About 4-0 record, one technical knockout. And also beat Joe Joyce as well. So Usyk gets ready. Nice gulp of water for Mundungo. He'll have to use his power early on, keep his opponent at arm's length. But in truth, really, the Thunder weren't expecting a victory tonight. They were looking 4-1 would be a wonderful result to take to Ukraine. Of course, with the Astana, the destination for the final. And final, of course, May 10th and 11th at the Sariaka Velodrome in Astana, in Kazakhstan's capital, at 9,000-seater.
Shake hands.
Velodrome venue is the prize for one of these teams. And this is just the halfway stage, of course. the first leg of the semi-final. He'll return next week in Ukraine. And for Mudungo, big ask this evening. Can he produce a fairy tale? Yeah, the heavyweights dominating the stage. Both boxers heavily tattooed. And, at the moment, music just feeling his way in. Dungo staying up out of reach, trying to unleash a big right. Juzek coming forward at the moment. Unable to unleash anything, and it's Dungo's find the target twice already. That's a positive start for the Italian. Just waiting, he's very fast, quick technique, quick hands, as well as the power. He's being patient at the moment. Dungo turns back into the corner, needs to come out and unleash a right, which he does, and does it very well, comes forward again, that's good aggression. With the left as well, and the left finds a way through once more. Good start from Dungo. Covers up once more. Leaning in with the left, but can't find a way through. Back to orthodox style. Trying to open up Mudungo. But the Italian's having none of it so far. Covering up very well. As it comes forward, the right doesn't find its way through. Mudungo stays out of reach once more. Music not. That big right over the top. Being aggressive now. Mudungo. He's down. Knee. The gloves cleaned. Took that shot to the head there. And uppercut. And Usyk in the last 10. And he's being aggressive now. And he's really got Mudungo in the corner here. And unleashing a couple of big, powerful shots. Sending Mudungo back. And Usyk looks out into the audience. He knows he's a superstar. Mudungo's got to really cover up, and he's got to be a bit more aggressive himself. He started aggressively, which was good, but once Usyk opened up, he was right on the back foot. He's caught there. Stunned. Caught with the left and the right. Those shots tell their own story. Usyk who takes it the first round.
Seconda ripresa, second round.
Francesco Damiani, the Thunder coach there. He's a former heavyweight, of course. He's been around, he knows what needs to be done. He wants his man to be more aggressive. And give it a go. Took the contest at Usyk. A little bit open there. Mudungo. He's Joseph keeps coming forward, waiting for the moment to unleash. Big right of his. And it does the right, the left waiting behind. And it's the right, the left comes over. It's the right that does the damage once more. And body shot from the southpaw. Left and the right, the top of the head and the body, upstairs, downstairs at the moment. But Madungo holds his ground, takes the body punches, and those body punches, when you're sitting ringside, you can feel them, and they're sapping the energy of Madungo in this second round. Another wonderful left, and the left is really doing the damage, and Madungo felt that it was in low. He went down, and he nearly dropped to his knees again. He can come forward. He's had a look over to the corner, but he's really struggling here. And Usyk stepped in again, and that's it. Then the referee's seen enough, and the superstar stops the contest. Technical knockout. Madungo really out of his depth there against Alexander Usyk, who just shows his quality, and there's no doubt about it, who is the top man there. But Madungo came up against an Olympic champion, a world champion, a superstar World Series of Boxing, and he's nothing to... to really... be disheartened about. He came up against a champion, a true champion. It was tough for Madungo. It was tough in the first round as well, and really in the second round, those body blows, the left and then the big right, and then that left again. He was waiting for the left, and he just went down. He couldn't take any more punishment, and in the end the referee had to stop it. And there you go. And as we expected, the Ukraine Ottomans definitely picking up the victory. We knew they would, but 4-1 is good for the Thunder. There's no doubt about that.
Knockout at the second round. The winner is blue corner, Oleksandr Usyk.
Oleksandr Usyk with a technical knockout gives Ukraine a very important point. And he is certainly a wonderful competitor, and there's no doubt about his Olympic, he's a world champion as well. But overall, Dolce Gabbana, Italia Thunder can take heart from this evening. They produced four excellent bouts. They picked up four victories, one defeat in the end. It was expected, but we're really expecting that. Usyk just too strong for Madungo. But overall, Italia Thunder will head to Ukraine with their hopes high, and of course with Astana, the goal at the end of it all for the finals, as I say, 10th and 11th of May. But in the meantime, it's been a wonderful evening of boxing for us. World Series of Boxing, semi-finals first leg. It's Dolce Gabbana who take the advantage over Ukraine Ottomans 4-1. That's all from me, Richard Whittle. Hope you've enjoyed. I'm sure you have. And we'll see you very soon for more World Series of Boxing.